Hi, I'm Peter Travers, the movie critic for Rolling Stone magazine, and it's time for us to talk again about what to see at the movies this weekend. And I'm telling you, it is hell out there. And I'm not talking just about the Joshua Jackson horror movie Shudder, where he and his newlywed wife, Rachel Taylor, see images in their photographs that weren't there. Doesn't it make you feel that you've seen this movie maybe 24 times? Or you could go see something as dreadful as Drillbit Taylor. It's gonna look good to you because it's produced by Judd Apatow, it's got Owen Wilson in it. And Owen Wilson is a guy hired by three school kids to be their bodyguard. And I'm telling you, that joke, that's it. For 2 hours, it's that joke over and over and over again. He's supposed to be a tough bodyguard, but he's not, he's a wuss. This is terrible out there. We are in a state of movie emergency. You're saying, what do I do now? I'm saying, you stay home and you watch TV. And if you have HBO, you watch John Adams. And if you don't have HBO, go to somebody's house who does have HBO and sit with them. I can hear you saying it to me now. John Adams, I know. It sounds like homework. It sounds like virtuous. It sounds like David McCullough's Pulitzer Prize winning biography turned into a 7-part miniseries that will be running till the end of April, lasting 8.5 hours with Paul Giamatti, of all people, in a wig. And groan, go ahead. Take that moment out there and groan to yourself. But I'm telling you, this is amazingly good stuff. There's nothing old hat about this. Giamatti's performance in this, I think, is something almost like a consummate piece of acting. And a lot of people, and some of them critics, have criticized him. And they said, this guy looks like Shrek. He doesn't look like John Adams. What in the world were they thinking to hire him? Look, Giamatti looks like the real John Adams look. You don't hire Brad Pitt to play John Adams. Maybe you can, when they make the Thomas Jefferson story, they can hire him. John Adams was a Boston lawyer, unprepossessing in looks. Giamatti gets it right. And Laura Linney, playing his wife Abigail, gets it right just as well as Giamatti does. They are terrific together.
That certain principles are eternal. And that men of great minds have. Why are you laughing?
This was a real passionate love relationship through letters back and forth. And what you get over these 7 parts is history, but history made flesh and blood. Giamatti has played in Sideways. He's been the wine snob. Last year he was Santa Claus. Now he's John Adams. I said to him recently, what's left for you? And he said, only Jesus Christ. So I'm not sure that I want to see that one. But I think this is an actor who takes risks. I give credit to Tom Hanks for being the executive producer of this project. He probably had to force it down HBO's throat because who wants to make an 8.5-hour movie about American history? Hanks was right to do this. He was right to fight for Giamatti to play it and for Laura Linney to play Abigail. I don't want to hear you say the words Drillbit Taylor. I want you to say John Adams. I'm Peter Travers.